Okay, now we're going to remove the carriage assembly with the ink tube assembly nozzles off the carriage. We're going to release the belt off the motor head on this side by releasing the tension idler on this side. And here's the encoder strip back here that tells the carriage where it's at on the axis. So we have to remove that screw here, which will remove this plate, and then we can release tension off the idler and then remove this tension assembly. Okay, release pressure off the encoder strip. When you reassemble the carriage assembly, you got to make sure the encoder strip is in the slot right there where the sensor is, right back here, or else the carriage will not know its position on the axis and it will give you an error. Take off this plate and remove this screw. And also screw in here. There's a idler tensioner right here that this is a new style. You don't need a screwdriver. Just use a flathead screwdriver. Pull back on that idler like so, and it'll click in place, and then it releases tension on the belt. Tension release, you come down to the other end and pull the belt over the motor head to release it. When you're replacing a belt, it's very common they have ground belt residue in your head of your motor. I use a small flat screwdriver and just pry out any debris that may be in that motor head. This one looks fine. Also, when I have the carriage off, I clean the rail front and back of the residue. Damp paper towel, just water's all you need. See, this one's got a lot of ink. Water's really good for cleaning up that sort of stuff. This is trailing cable back here. Okay, with the tension off, I can release this. The idler pulleys inside. Can be released. That's how the belt comes off. Now, moving on to the most critical component is the trailing cable. This is the trailing cable as it connects to the carriage assembly. And we're going to have to release this plastic.